Hello friends, this is Dr. Shashi Agarwal. I welcome you all, assuming you all are safe and enjoying the life. Today our topic is the concept of money supply. It is relevant for the student of economics for finance, also relevant for the UGC economics students, also relevant for the various students who are preparing for the competitive exam. This topic is also relevant for the plus two commerce and plus two economics. Its Hindi lecture is available at my second channel, that is the Shashi Agarwal Economics and Blog Classes. If you find my lecture useful, please do subscribe my both channel, Shashi Agarwal and Shashi Agarwal Economics and Blog Classes. Before explaining the concept of money supply, this is my app. This is my WhatsApp number 7971-79091. A link of this app I will be sharing in the description box. This app is relevant for the student of economics and management. Various courses related to commerce economics management have been uploaded. Economics for finance is also uploaded at this app. Link I will be sharing. Methodology is live and recorded lectures, descriptive and summarized notes. Doubt session will be there. Personal attention will be paid to the students and test series will be there to help out the student. Even I have created a Telegram group, the link of which I will be sharing in the description box. So you could also join that Telegram group. So what is the meaning of supply of money? When we talk about the supply of money, what does it convey? It's a stock concept. What is a stock concept? It means on a particular day, how much we have the supply of money. So when we talk about the supply of money, it means total stock of money, which includes paper notes, coins, and demand deposits of bank in circulation, which is held by the public at any particular time. So this public is very important. So money supply, which is in circulation, which is held by the public, and it's a stock concept, which means at any particular time. So when we talk about the supply of money, what is covered? Paper notes, coins, and demand deposits of bank. Money supply is the stock of money circulation on some specific day. Like I say, what is the supply of money on 31st March? So that is the stock concept. So what is the meaning of demand deposits? These are the funds which are held by an account from which deposit fund could be withdrawn at any time. Like we are having saving account, current account. But it excludes those accounts which have limited withdrawals or transfers. Supply of money does not include the supply of money which is held by the government and stock of money which is held by the banking system of a country. Supply of money includes only that stock of money which is held by the people. It does not include the money which is held by the supplier of money. So supply of money refers to that stock of money which is held by those who demand money, not those who are the supplier of the money. So what is the meaning of public? The term public is defined to include all economic units. It means households, it means firms, it means institution, but excluding the producer of the money, that is the government and banking system. The term public includes all the local authorities, non-banking financial corporations, non-departmental public sector undertaking, foreign central banks, foreign government, an international monetary fund which hold a part of Indian money in bank in the form of the deposits with the RBI. So we could say the public means household, firms and institution excluding the supplier of the money and inclusive of some authorities which I have explained. Money supply. The quantity of money could be measured. It's a measurable concept. The supply of money is stock variable, I have told, on particular date, how much stock we are having. It refers to money at a particular point of time. If there is an increase or decrease in money, monthly or yearly, that is a flow. The stock of money always refers to the stock of money which is available to the public as for the payment and the money which could be stored. So what is the significance of the money supply? Increasing money supply affects the process of economic development, and also we have to control the supply of money so we could achieve the price stability in the economy. There should be controlled expansion of money supply for achieving the objective of development stability. Healthy growth of the economy signifies there should be neither inflation. Inflation means consistent rise in the prices. Mild inflation is much better than the growth of economy. But runaway inflation is bad for the economy. So management of money supply is very important if we want to achieve the steady economic growth. Because in the economy, there is an inflation situation, there is a deflation situation. So controlling the inflation and deflation, the suitable monetary policy, suitable money supply is maintained so to control the inflation and deflation and achieve the objective with the stability. So who are the supplier of the money? It's the government, which issues 1 rupee note and all other coins. RBI, which issue paper currency on the basis of money reserve of rupees 200 crore in the form of gold and the foreign security. Out of 200 crore, the value of the gold should be 115 crore. In India, RBI is the principal supplier of the money. So high-powered money, which is issued by the monetary authority, is the source of all other form of money. The currency, which is issued by the RBI and the government, is fiat money, and its value is granted by the government. So what is the fiat money? Refer to that money which is issued by the order or authority of the government. It includes all the notes and coins which the people of the country are legally bound to accept as a medium of exchange. So fiat money is a legal tender money. So it also, the supply of money also covers the credit creation or bank money which is created by commercial banks against the deposits. So reserve held by the commercial bank with RBI is the part of the high powered money, but that is not included in the money supply. High powered money is the sum total of currency which is held by the people, vault cash of the commercial bank, cash reserve of the commercial bank with the Reserve Bank of India. High powered money is also called the base money in the economy, but we have to keep in mind the reserve held by the commercial banks and the vault cash of the commercial bank is a part of the high powered money. But not, that is not included in the money supply. So there are alternative 4 measures of money supply, which we will be explaining in other lecture: M1, M2, M3, M4. M1 is the currency with the public, demand deposit with the people and commercial bank, and other deposits with the RBI. Now we'll see what is the meaning of demand deposits with and the commercial bank. It covers demand deposit with RBI, financial institution NABARD, demand deposit with RBI of foreign central banks and government, demand deposit of international financial institutions like IMF and the World Bank. Rest we will cover in the next video.